Dear viewers, welcome to the YouTube channel H2O Chemistry. So in our last video, we have discussed about the question and answers of very short answers. So to continue with that, so I'm going to discuss the reasoning questions in this video. So let's go to the first questions of reasoning. Aluminium foil are used to wrap food items. Foil they mention. So the foil is a thin sheet, very thin sheet. We can easily fold it. So how to make sheets? Very simple. The metals can be beaten into sheets or else drawn into sheets. This property is called malleability. So the aluminium foil, they said, so the aluminium is malleable, can be drawn into thin sheets, and which is a very soft metal, so can easily fold it and does not react with food items. So for these reasons, the aluminium foil is used in the wrapping of food items. The next question, immersion rods for heating liquids are made up of metallic substances. Yes, you might have watched, to heat a water, the generally they used to have a U-type metallic rod which is connected to the electrical switch, so that the electrical energy can be converted into heat energy. The heat energy is transferred from the metal rods to the water, so the water gets heated. So you might have seen at homes, generally they don't have the heaters at the bathroom, they usually have this metal rods to heat it, right? So this is an idea. So metal are very good conductors of electricity, so that property is used. So metals are usually good conductors of heat and electricity, hence metals are used for making immersion rods. Even not only at home I'm talking about, whereas in many industries the metal rods are used to conduct the electricity, so that electricity can be converted into heat energy, so that liquid gets heats up. The next one, doctor prescribe a tablet to a patient suffering from iron deficiency. The tablet does not look like iron. Yes, if any person is suffered from anemia, the doctor used to prescribe iron tablets. Actually, the iron tablets does not look like iron because the tablet contains compounds of iron like ferrous sulfate and ferrous citrate, like that. So when during digestion, the ferrous ion and the sulfate ion will split up, or ionization takes place. So the ferrous ion is a remedy for the anemia. So during digestion, salt breakdown, iron breakdown, and then the salt of iron breakdown, and the iron purify the disease. The ferrous ion purify the disease. So hence the iron tablets does not look like iron, so it looks like an ferrous sulfate or ferrous citrate. So the nature of the compounds, see, we already learned that the properties of the components are very different from the properties of the compound, so this property is applicable here. So that is, we have to understand. So ferrous ion and sulfate ion will have a different property when compared to the ferrous sulfate. So this actually you have to understand. So the tablet will not look like iron, instead it looks like a ferrous sulfate salt, the color of the salt it looks like. So what is the answer? Iron tablet does not contain iron metal, rather it contains iron salts like ferrous sulfate, ferrous citrate, etc. On heating these tablets during digestion, the salt of iron break down, hence iron tablet does not look like iron, which is actually a metal in element. Next one. Sodium and potassium are stored in kerosene. Yes, sodium and potassium are highly reactive metals. So they react vigorously with the air. For example, oxygen, moisture present in the air, so that it causes an explosion. So you can see that it's an explosion reaction. So hence these metals usually kept in kerosene, because this metal does not react with kerosene. That's an idea. Mercury, and it prevents the contact, and also sodium and potassium, when you keep it in kerosene, the kerosene prevents the contact between the air and this metal, So that is the reason we usually keep sodium and potassium in kerosene. Mercury, next question. Mercury is used in thermometers. Yes. See, we know that the only metal which is available in liquid state is mercury. The purpose we use in thermometer is it has a high coefficient of expansion. Even with a very small difference in the temperature, it expands. So we can easily monitor that temperature. It has a high boiling point. Yes, it has a very high boiling point. That is the reason even a very high temperature we can measure with this temperature change we can measure. That is the reason we use mercury in our thermometer. The next one. Why wires cannot be drawn from materials like stone and wood? Okay, the first question is wires. Why wires? What is the use of wire? The use of wire is to conduct the electricity normally in our domestic purpose. So wires are normally used for conducting electricity. But stone and wood are non-conductors of electricity. So the purpose is entirely different. Wires we need it for conducting electricity, whereas stone and wood are non-conductors. So hence they are not used in the making of wires. Very simple idea. So stones and wood are non-conductor of electricity. So that is an answer. Now let us go to the, so we are in the end of this lesson. So I'm going to give a small mind map or concept map of this lesson, so that you will understand more about this. The matter can be classified into solid, liquid and gas. So the solids, we have elements, we have metals and non-metals. In solids we have elements, metals and non-metals. So there is only one metal available in liquid state is mercury. Other metals like copper, iron, gold are the examples. Similarly, non-metal only available in liquid form is bromine. Other non-metal we have carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, etc. And compounds in solid states, right? Solid state, and they have definite shape and definite volume. They are rigid and hard. For example, sodium chloride, silicon dioxide, sand, and then calcium carbonate, right? Limestone, and they do not flow, we know very well. Come to the next one, liquids. Compound in liquids, for example, water, hydrochloric acid, this is an example. They do not have a shape, and they less likely packed, and they have a definite volume. They take the shape of container. They have a definite volume. They take the shape of the container. Next one, come to the gases. For example, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen. Compounds in gases, example, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, ammonia, etc. They don't have a definite shape, definite volume that can be compressed, and no free surface. There is no surface for this one, gases. This is a mind map. You can learn from this. The whole lesson is completed. Thanks for watching. We'll see in the next video. If you like this video, subscribe and click the bell button to get the notifications immediately. Like this video and share it. Thank you.